All right, traders, welcome to today's recap. It is the 15th of November, and this is your recap from the Tribeca Trade Group. So, wow, what a move today in various different sectors. A lot of earnings to go through. One of those days where you have to keep your head on a swivel because the news, headline risk, all of the above really fueling the markets today. So let's break it down. So what do we want to tackle first for the day? Let's talk a little bit about some of the moves in retail, which I know CNBC is talking a little bit about. This was, you know, showing some strength, you know, about 2 weeks ago was one of the better looking sectors. But one by one, some names have reported. And it's a good case, you know, so Walmart is one of those names that has been acting really well. But, you know, again, a little bit too overbought, you know, into earnings. So that's why, you know, we kind of look for trades and then take them off once they get a little bit overbought, because this market is not one that is really liking, you know, overbought names into events. Just not the right market for that to hold into, hold names into. So Walmart was a great trade for us a couple weeks ago. But you could see what they're saying basically out of their earnings. You know, there looks like their comps, their margins, and this kind of sent a little bit of a tailspin as well as Dillard's. So it's been one by one, and it's just amazing how quickly this all happens. But one by one, now everybody hates the retailers. And a couple names that reported here after the close. And, you know, not even that bad results out of Nordstrom's. But once people get this idea in their head that they don't want, you know, this group anymore, and then, you know, results come out and they're a little bit lackluster, they get smoked, right? Everything kind of, you know, goes by the wayside here. So as I'm trying to bring up the Nordstrom chart, you could see that was Pronoma was hit pretty hard. But I don't know. It seems like a little bit of overreaction. I could tell you from a options standpoint of view, the same thing. Today, everybody buying puts in all the retail names today. Macy's saw some big blocks of puts go up. Ulta, which is, you know, if you wanted to short one name, I would say a name that's gone up probably a little bit too much is Ulta. There was some January puts, small order, but somebody's thinking that way. Dick's Sporting Goods saw some puts. So there was about five different names in the retail group that has been seeing, saw some put buyers today. So that's the one sector. So, you know, I don't know if there's many opportunities. I think you kind of have to let this play out a little bit. And we'll see how the Black Friday sales are, which I'm guessing also that people are buying puts because they don't think that the numbers are going to be as good as what they've been the last couple of years. So that's a trade to kind of think about. So yeah, I see CNBC talking about a couple names in retail. You know, I do think Ross Stores is probably best in breed in this group. As well as TGX, which they just mentioned on CNBC. This name reports earnings. So if I was going to take a swing on a retail name, maybe it would be Ross Stores. But they have this habit, the CEO, or maybe even afterwards, they have this habit of sandbagging their numbers. So maybe watch to buy the dip after that on good numbers. Next group. Next, NVIDIA. This was not a name that I thought was a good idea to play on earnings. I did not want to buy puts in NVIDIA just because I think it's a best-in-breed name. But where's this thing at? 170. Notice where this is at. Notice there's a VPOC lingering down here, version point of control, right around here, 170. So this looks like it'll be taken out and back to the October, probably taken out the October lows. But bad numbers, I would say. Personally, I don't have a reason to buy this in the after hours. They missed. They not only, you know, I think what people have been really crucial on is guidance, but NVIDIA missed their numbers, and they missed on the top line and the bottom line. So I don't really have a great reason to buy this. Also, Applied Materials is also down. So a lot of bad news after hours. This one's also down on what I thought was kind of priced in, but I guess not. But they had some bad numbers and talked about some bad things in their quarter. I don't know why this name is up, PCG. We did see some calls at the end of the day. Granted, if you want to look at this in Trade Alert, you could see that there was some March calls that were being bought. These went up against open interest, but look at the strike, 60 on these. So I don't know, would I buy the 60 strike calls? You know, notice the implied volatility, very expensive calls. So yes, they did buy the 25 calls. Where's this thing trading now? 24. It's tough. I think this is a better name to you know, if I were to play it, which I did not, I would have just bought the stock, a $17 stock. Why are you going to mess with the calls at that price? I don't know, considering the implied volatility in these things. But anyway, nice move. It looks like it's back to the open from where we were. It was down 30% today, PCG. So back to 23, which again, I think is right around the opening print. Okay, so that's 5 minutes of just talking about some of the sector moves. A lot of headlines today. I'll tell you a little bit about what I did today. If you've been watching my midday video or my or yesterday's video, I've been talking a lot about China, not so much because of a possible deal, but just looking at the technicals, right? I started with BABA yesterday. So, you know, if you're not a member of Tribeca Trade Group, you know, I could tell you from number why you should think about becoming a member is because, I really feel I'm about a day ahead of people normally talking about this type of stuff. But I saw a lot of people posting charts on BABA today. When did I post it? Yesterday. So, like I said, I'm not trying to pat myself on the back, but I'm usually a day ahead. Also, the news. You get the news faster than anybody else. We were on top of two different headlines before everybody else. The second one was the market moves right away, but the first one that we caught, and we've got great teamwork in our trading room. It's full transparency and it's full. Everybody gets information from different places. I get a great news source, from Bloomberg is amazing with the news that they put out, as they should be. It's expensive, but somebody else saw the FT article that came out, and we had a good 5 minutes to kind of mess around before the market started to react to it. So, you know, those are the two reasons. Some of the traders that we have in the room are just amazing at not only trading, but getting the news before anybody else. And then second of all, you know, I've been pretty spot on, I would say, with coming out with ideas. And my idea, basically for today, why I kind of took a shot at going long some things is because I think that you know, the market moves in waves, right? I mean, everybody is starting to, the bad news has been so apparent that I thought if we get any type of good news, and, you know, we did get this headline today on China. Again, whether or not you believe that kind of stuff is another thing, but the market reacts to it and shorts cover. So today could be a short cover rally that we saw rather than new longs really being put to work. But you're going to have these herky-jerky moves in either sideways or a market that could be in we could be more in a bearish trend for the time being, but you're going to have snapback rallies, and those are not the times to get short. I would rather put a little bit of money to work and then be quick with taking targets. You know, targets are a big thing. This is not the right market, I think, to sit and hold. If you put a trade on and it works, my philosophy is making sure that you're taking a good portion of that trade off and then leaving the rest on. So what's going on here in this BABA chart? To me, it kind of looks like a reverse head and shoulders, and its first break over the 50. When's the last time this thing broke over the 50-day moving average? Back here, which was a false break. So, you know, you're going to have overhead resistance here, but for a trade, I think this makes sense, and you've got an easy price, 150.59, to kind of go versus. If you look at the whole group, if you want to look at FXI, it's kind of the same thing. It's really washed out. And if you look at some of the names that are reporting, if you're paying attention, and you know, again, we came upon. I should have this from yesterday, but yeah, I put out yesterday, you know, I put some notes on it. Also, the setup that I've been talking about on the weekly chart as well, that it's been holding in support on the weekly chart, which is 138, also a level to trade against. But besides Baba, if you look at some of the names that I've been reporting, look at what Wuba did today, and they beat on the top line and the bottom line. So if you're paying attention, maybe something else is kind of going. And again, this has nothing to do. I guess it does have something to do. It will get an extra kicker if they manage to get close on a trade, which again I still don't have tons of faith in. And this meeting, you know, who knows what happens in that meeting that's going to happen. But some names are starting to beat their numbers. That has nothing to do with trade. So that's Wuba had a good quarter. Vips also, there were some post calls. This is again $5 stock. So it's again just thinking trade wise and technical, you know, what your fundamental view is on China, it's washed out in my opinion. So what's your risk here? I would say maybe 470. If I took a shot at this, I bought some shares of VIPS. Big downtrend, right? But as long as you're defining, you know, way below the 200-day moving average, but this, you can't wait for it to get above the 200-day moving average. It's all the way, it would be a double, right? So as long as I'm defining my risk, which I think is basically a dollar of risk, 470. Or if you want to use the point of control, you could do that too, because really I'm looking for this thing to move quickly and for basically a move up to $7. All right, so again, counter trend trades for today. And we noticed this yesterday with the Chinese internet ETF. While everything else was going down, this was not. So I know I'm duplicating what I've talked about, but you know, this is what has me a little bit excited about the market right now. And if you look at the relationship between... Oh, by the way, I wanted to point this out before I change. I had this up for a reason. The market's not down that much after hours on NVIDIA because it's not that big of a weight in the queues. It's only 1.5% weight, you know, versus some of these bigger names in here. But if you look at the relationship, so again, I've gone over this now like 3 or 4 times, but just in case you haven't seen it, you could look at the relationship either between FXI. And SPY, just to see this updated. It's good to kind of take a look at it because it now is updated at the end of the day. But I sent this out earlier, and FXI is now outperforming SPY over the last month. You could see right here. All right, so that's a little bit of a change in trend, I would say. So good to see something. I'm sticking with emerging markets, and you could also look at emerging markets this way, which I did not bring up this chart, so I'll be happy to bring it up. But if you look at EEM versus SPY, right, because this has China and it's got Brazil in it, it's got India in it, it's got South Korea in it, same thing. And if you look at EWZ, if you don't want to touch China, which I don't blame you with the tape bombs that are going on, look at the chart of Brazil. Brazil is up 2.4%, a nice bounce off the 200-day moving average. All right, so to look at, I know I'm starting with, you know, I went over a couple of sectors. We could talk a little bit about the technicals, which, you know, again, I don't really trade the S&P. So, you know, I do look at it for reference to say, okay, what's going on here in the overall U.S. market. But I really like to look under the hood because that will tell me enough with what's going on with sectors. But, yeah, we do look like we have a bullish engulfing candle for the day, and I'm seeing that in a couple different places. Let's look at IWM, which honestly I haven't looked at an IWM chart all day today, but nice recovery. I was moaning yesterday. I thought XBI was a big problem area yesterday, taking out the October lows, but this could be a false breakdown. It's got to get above. It's got to get back into value. It's got to get back above, what is it, 78? I think it's 77.99, so let's call it 78 would be a move back into. But again, I know a couple of traders who played this for a rebound today, very nicely played. So 78 is the bogey there for this to get back and maybe be a false breakdown. I don't know, too early to call it that. But again, XBI, something to watch because it is a good gauge of risk. Also IGV, which is the software ETF, bullish engulfing there as well. And I was looking at a particular name in this space that just recently had earnings. Zebra, I sent this chart out. Good earnings, bullish engulfing. Not bad. Another name that I liked that had good earnings was Zen, coming back up 5.4% today. And, again, I like easy trades. I don't like when it takes me a long time to analyze a trade and to look at the chart and say, this could happen, that could happen. Basically, go long versus here. Or if you want to wait another day so you have the 200-day moving average, but I would basically use 5433 or this low in here, right? You're, again, defining your risk on a trade. But that looks interesting to me as well. And I could go through more of those charts, but I don't want to, I'm not going to keep the video for that on for that much longer. So that's the main things that I wanted to cover for today. We'll see how the market takes these semi earnings tomorrow. I think it's one day at a time. Would I be looking at more shorts in a couple days? Yeah, if we bounce a little bit more, bounce into resistance. The one thing, oh, this is, I wanted to talk a little bit about strategy and what helps me kind of see things a little bit more clearly is when my positions are really light. I really took down my, a couple of positions, maybe that I didn't have to. So it really helps me to be super light in here so I could be super kind of quick and not be tied down to positions. Because when you're tied down to positions, you're basically wishing and hoping that your positions will work. If I can kind of rearrange positions, or if I can kind of be very nimble and have less positions on, especially in options, it allows me to kind of really think about things objectively. A couple other charts, by the way, and of course, this video, as all of them are, for information purposes only. Google may not be showing you anything great when looking at this daily chart, but if you drill into the 1 hour chart, it's been kind of sleepy. Notice that it held the value area for the, or it's back inside value for the week. And look at this, it's actually showing some a little bit of signs of life. And look at the volume. And if you go to the 5 minute, it may just help you see the peaks of what we did this week. Right? Basically nothing. Every time we got to this level, this what is this, 1065, it stalled out. Today it didn't stall out. So I will tomorrow and we did go ahead and I did throw on a trade in this in Google for today. So I think it looks I think it looks compelling. Notice this VPOC. We use this for a day trade. Again, what a great job these VPOCs do on my charts. Right up into the VPOC and sold off. Very much how a version point of control works. Again, why is that? Real briefly, look at the volume here. Right, so volume or price always has a memory to it. Buyers and sellers come back to the same areas. All right, so that's it for today. The last thing I would say about EEM and FXI, look at the volume, by the way, on these moves. So it's definitely trading good volume, and I think it's trying to put in put in a bottom here. I'm starting to get more and more turn on to it. All right, so that's it for today's video. Have a great night. See you tomorrow.